This tutorial is a brief overview of how to upload files to Phoca Download. Phoca Download is an extension for Joomla. It's a free extension, and it is used for giving access to people to download files of various formats. You can also use some security levels in order to control who can download those files as well. So in this tutorial, I just want to show how to upload files through Phoca Download and assign them to a category so they're available for people that you give access to on your website. The example site I'm using right now is FSNA Fraser Valley West. It's National Association of Federal Retirees here in Canada. It's one of the branches in British Columbia. And as you'll see, I already have a link set up here for Office, which links to the Phoca Download area. And for those of you who actually are working on this particular site, ordinarily Office does not show up unless you're logged in with the board or executive access. But I've logged in just so we can see how the changes happen here. If I click on Office, we'll see these six areas, six categories that exist in the Phoca Download area of this site. And you'll see it's 0, 0. So this is 0 subcategories, 0 files. But we're going to change that right now. Let's go. I'm in the back end of the of that site. And we're going to go to, I've already logged in, we're going to go to Components and to Phoca Download. Let's just go to Control Panel. Now, if you are setting up Phoca Download, or it's already set up on your site, but you need some new categories, right, some new areas to sort the files that you want to offer for download, you do that by creating a category. And of course, we would just click on this categories link right here. We'll click on that, and you'll see here's the existing six categories that correspond to the categories already on the site. If you want it to make a new category, let's say you just click new, and you would give it the title that you want. Let's just call this song lyrics. And the category would take this name. You could also make it a subcategory of an existing category. There's other aspects, other options that can be used here. Here is where you would put a description of the category. So that's how you create categories. Very easy. I'm not going to save this right now. Just go cancel. We'll work with these six here. Next, once you have your categories that you want to upload your files to, you want to click on Files. So we could click on Files here in the side menu, or if you're in the Control Panel, click on Files here. Now, there's just a couple of steps that need to be done in the proper order for everything to work out. First of all, we're going to add a new file to Phoca Download. So I'll click New, and here we have a place to put a title for the file. So I have created two sample files. One is a sample Word document, so I'm just going to title that right there for the title of it. Where do I want to make this? We'll just skip alias. That will be assigned by the website, the software. Now, which category do we want to put this in? Why don't we put it in the, we'll put it in Other, since it certainly is an Other type file. That's great. Now, the next thing that we want to do is link this particular file to the file that would be downloaded, all right? So, to do that, instead of typing in the name here, what we do is we click Select File Name. And what that will do is we'll open up the folders within the website where documents are stored in Phoca Download. And right now there's only one called User Upload. But why don't we create one that will match the category that exists in Phoca Download. Now we see here grayed out, but it's Other. So I'm going to create a folder. I click on there, and I'm going to create a folder within this root. Here's where things are right now. Within this root, and I'm going to call it Other, and I'll create that folder. Now, there it is there. Now, I want to upload a file that is this sample Word document. Now, it's going to upload to the folder that I am viewing. And where I'm viewing is just in this Phoca download folder. I want to put it in this other folder. And this just sort of helps keep things organized in the back end of the site. So when I click Other, now we're viewing the other folder. It says there is no file, but that's going to change in a second. Next, we'll go Choose File. And when I click Choose File, it's going to open up a window that shows where files are on my computer. And here is an example Word document that I created. So I could click that and click Open, or I can double click. And now it's there ready to be uploaded. I click Start Upload. It's uploaded, and now it shows up in the list of documents, example Word document.docx. Now all I have to do is click on that document name, and it will be put in the file name, and that's all we need to do. Now there's other things you can put down here. You could put a version, you could put an author name, author's website. These are all options for the different ways that Phoca download would be used, so you can check those out. If you want a confirm license, if you're going to have a license somewhere on your site where people have to accept that if they download this file, you're not responsible for anything that happens, you could set that up and you can say yes, you have to confirm the license, and somewhere in there we'd have to create that, so we'll deal with that in another tutorial. Basically, we can go down, you can click which user has uploaded the file, or you can leave that blank. Finally, down here, we get to description, and this is where you could do it. This is just like putting in any article or any content in Joomla. So this is a sample, oops, that's not spelled very well. This is a sample Word document to download from Phoca download. That's pretty much all that we need to do now. And we've saved it in other. There are other things that can be checked out here. Publishing options, when to start publishing this file, when to remove it. Plenty of options. I'll leave you to explore. If you have any questions, send me, leave a comment and I'll try to answer them, or maybe make another tutorial. Metadata options, if you want this document, these files to be found on the internet, this is a great place to put in the description and keywords. And mirror details, if you were running a site that was somewhere else, if you have a mirror site because you're getting lots of traffic, you can set that up. And YouTube options, if you're using this to handle YouTube videos. But basically, we'll go back to general options. Sample Word documents are title. We've already uploaded it. And I'm just going to go save. Now, when we save that, I'm going to go back here to the front end of the site where we have 00 for other. I'm going to refresh this page, and now we'll see we have 0 subcategories in other, but we do have one file. And when I click other and go into that area, now we see that example Word document.docx there ready for download, and there's the description that we typed for it. If we click download, it asks us where we want to download the file to on our computer. And when someone's downloading this, of course, it's important for them to remember which folder it ends up going to, otherwise kind of get lost. But they can always download it another time. So we could save and it downloads. And that's how to upload a file to make available according to your permissions that you set up in Phoca Download. So why don't we just do one more file? Let's go back to this tab. Here we've got the previous one open, so I'm just going to, I'll just save it and close. Let's do a new file. We'll click New, and then we'll go give it a title. This time, that's a sample PDF file that I've made. Right. Leave the alias. Let's put it in the same folder, Other. All right. File name, Let's select the file name. Now the file is not yet up on a server yet, and we already have this folder that was created that is basically the same name as other, the other category. So let's go into that folder once again. You have to do that each time you upload a file. There's the Word document that we uploaded, but now let's choose a different file. And then we'll use this file here, example PDF document. Double click on it. It's already chosen there. We see its name sort of there. Sorry. Oh, I have to choose that again. All right. There's its name truncated because it doesn't fit in between these two buttons, but we know it's there. Now we'll click Start Upload. It's now uploaded to the server to this file location. Example PDF document. So we'll just click that title. It's there. Go through all these other options if you're interested in them or are using them. And we'll give this a description. This is an example PDF file to download. And I think that's all we need to do. So we're just going to go save and close. Now when we go, let's just refresh this page. We're already in the other category. And now we have two files. We have this Word document and we have this PDF document. And there's the description we just typed. Why don't we download it? I can even download it just by clicking on the name of the file. And I will save it to downloads. And when I click on that, there is the document that I just downloaded, that I had created. So that's sort of a basic tour of adding files to Phoca download and also creating categories into which you want to have your files organized. And I hope this tutorial helps. If you have any questions, leave a comment, and I hope you subscribe to the channel or even just give a thumbs up for the video. Thanks for watching. God bless.